Oh yeah. Gene Hammer's blowing in the background. Gene Hammer's blowing in the background. When I was young growing up, my community, age never fazed me. The other people were just a part of the community. That was it. The elderly people were just a part of the community. I guess I thought I was never going to get old. But my grandmother always preached that if you keep living, age is going to creep into your life without your permission. I was just too young to see past that thought. I was just too young to see past that thought. And my grandmother was a proud and independent woman with a bucket full of pride. She was a devoted Christian and educator. She was a survivor. But I saw her aging. I saw her aging for the first time. She used to call me to the house just to screw a light bulb in her lamps. I saw the young and vibrant grandmother be covered with old age. So much she couldn't cut her own toenails anymore. By then I was a young adult, but she still tried to hang on to her pride. And during those times, school teachers were proud and respected in the communities. They were like our guardian angels. My mind couldn't grasp what was happening to her. My grandfather had gone on, leaving her all alone. Now, since I'm a senior citizen, now I am beginning to flashback on my elders back then. Even though technology have increased the lifespan of elderly people, the idea of growing old is still frightening. It is fearful, not because of death, just not being able to function in this changing and complex society. Now I am coping with age every day since it has crept up on me, just like it did my father, my grandfather, my grandmother, and mother. This is why memories are therapeutic for the mind, especially the elderly. It is a good massage for the aging mind. It is a good massage for the aging mind. I have plenty of stories to last me forever. When I get depressed or stressed out, the power of writing cures and relaxes me through the day. And I try to stay in tune with my inner spirit, which is a good thing. I struggle sometimes, but at the end of the day, I am smiling at some of the precious memories I have lived. I count my blessings for the opportunity to have lived through some bad, to get to the good. As I sat one day gazing at my computer, wondering where should I start, then a poem about age popped up in my imaginary vision. I quickly went to my computer word processor and began to write. I called it Growing Old Gracefully. I'm going to repeat that. I called it Growing Old Gracefully, which my grandmother grew old gracefully until the end. This is coming from my book of collection, of my reflections. Here it is, and it goes like this. As I wrote, growing old gracefully, that human beings have yet been able to control. But growing old gracefully is another story. One can look back on all their glory, small or big, keeps them in the right leg. Good memories are always food for the mind of the aged. It makes one be thankful every day. The wise hang on to the wonderful past. Then some just hang on to the suffering that whipped their ass. Let me repeat that. Some just hang on to the suffering that whipped their ass. Oops, that's a slip. You didn't hear that coming from my lips. Growing old is something human beings have yet been able to control. Growing old gracefully is another story. And one thinks of all their glory. Letting go of a painful past is very hard to do, especially when history slaps the elderly in the face again and again every day, always reopening the same old case. But as time nears, and their lives are in constant fear, they remember the good old days that have brought them this far. It never caused a tear, knowing that God is all that's good and his footsteps are always near to protect them, from fear. That evening the writing was heavy on my mind. Up came the poem, Time. Time is a powerful force we can feel but can't see. It passes at a rapid speed, doing its deed. Time is a powerful force we can feel but can't see. It passes at a rapid speed, doing its deed through the universe. Time is a thing that is never idle while leaving behind so much change. Memory is its past, because time never lasts. It just can move into the next class. Time is a thing we all have to believe as it sweeps up the old dead leaves, never looking back at the same track. It passes through generations and carries people's spirits onto another foundation. Families are swept up one by one and the young take their place for another new day. The spirit of the old is transferred to the young. And time keeps on moving because it's not about to be a loser. It has a mind of its own and time spends it all alone. Time has no enemies, neither any friends. For it doesn't have to answer to anyone while rushing from around the bend, speeding into another trend. Time is a thing we can't see, but we can feel as it passes at a rapid speed, doing its deed. Time wraps us up into its arms, always keeping us alarmed. Sometimes giving our face a good slap, let us know we are only here for a short nap. To enjoy, be merry, and not contrary. And above all, be kind, for time moves on, and it sure would hate to leave all of us behind. It just kept flowing. The writing just kept flowing. It was as if I couldn't stop until the wee hours of the night. Writing is surely therapy for the mind and soul, especially the elderly. Hook up some words and play a little jazz in the background, and there you go. Because too many stories are not told, and the elderly takes all the stories with the humor, laughter, and history to the grave. When I was young, I thought the elderly was so funny when they told their stories to us. My grandfather was a ragtime piano player, and they said he could really play. But we wondered, how did he meet my grandmother, a devoted Christian? But then too, I didn't see a piano in the house. So I guess he gave up the ivory keys. I called it compromising, especially when you are in love. Love works in mysterious ways. There's an old saying, never underestimate the power of a woman. I smiled as I wrote this piece. An old man told me that while a man is sleeping, a woman is thinking. I was too young to think about that thought at the time, but I surely understand now what it meant. Like my grandmother told me, just keep living. The poem from my reflection, titled Woman. Woman is a part of this planet and sometimes taken for granted. Woman is more than what we see. She is a part of our destiny. Woman motivates success and fame. Let me repeat that. Woman motivates success and fame, even keeps man from a lot of shame when he is to blame. Woman is a free spirit, something she inherited, and her natural sense is sweet as a berry. She doesn't have to put up any defense, because God made her to be caring instead of daring. No matter what we think and see, any man would tell you that there is a queen bee in the midst that runs his show. And sometimes he doesn't care to know because of his little ego. Woman is a part of this planet and surely sometimes taken for granted. She loves the challenge because it is her God-given nature. And a man without balance is just another date on her calendar. Loving is more than woman under the sheets, even though man see it as a treat. But when things are no longer right between man and woman, that brings anger, all are forgotten and the love life is in danger. Once again, the two become strangers. Understanding woman is still a secret that man has yet to conquer. The man is not the Mr. Right. No matter how he loves under the sheets, she will fly away like a dove. But she is a being of nature, and surely she doesn't like to be shoved. Woman is a part of this planet and sometimes is taken for granted. She is more than what we see. She is a part of our destiny. This is dedicated to all the women out there. I understand now, after all these years, like my grandmother told me, just keep living. I know she is smiling now. Anyway, I was about finished for the night. My fingers was tired and my eyes was weary. I was ready for the bed. I thought I had written all the words out of my head until suddenly another thought appeared. Back to writing, I took a deep breath. Listened to a few sounds and wrote this, the piece called Creativity, which I will tell you on my next video. Chiming out.